Greetings. This video refutes argument number 6 from the silly flood list sent by someone in Islam. Let's look at the claim. Number 6. According to the Word of God, the Bible, the devil attacks your God, Jesus, and deprives him of food and drink for 40 days, and commanded Jesus to worship him. Matthew 4:8. But according to Muhammad's Quran, the Satan is called Kanas, the one who escapeth when the name of God is mentioned. Quran 1:14:4. Consider the purpose of this argument. It is trying to imply that the Quran is better simply because a statement in the Quran sounds like a better statement. First, let's examine how the Bible's message is grossly misrepresented by this claim. According to the Word of God, the Bible, 1. The devil attacks your God, Jesus, and 2. Deprives him of food and drink for 40 days. It's like he holds him hostage, tied up in a cave somewhere. 3. And commanded Jesus to worship him. The first thing to notice is that the whole story of the temptation of Jesus begins in Matthew 8:1. Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the desert to be tempted by the devil. The first thing to notice is Jesus was led by the Holy Spirit, not Satan, into the desert. Notice verse 1 does not say, then Jesus was led by the devil into the desert to be tempted by the devil. After fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. Second, notice Jesus fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. Jesus did not fast as Mohammedans do during Ramadan. Jesus did not have full meals every night. Jesus fasted 40 days and 40 nights. The tempter came to him and said, then the tempter came, when he thought Jesus would be weak and hungry from 40 days and nights without food. If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread. Shameless plug. You can watch my video on this topic where I demonstrate that this temptation actually proves Jesus is the Son of God. So Satan tries to tempt Jesus by his body's craving for food. And Jesus answered, it is written, man does not live by bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. So tempted with food after 40 days of fasting, Jesus is not tempted into sin. Then the devil took him to the holy city and had him stand on the highest point of the temple. This is where Mohammedans typically say Satan carried Jesus like a sack of potatoes. That always gives me a good laugh. If you are the Son of God, he said, clearly Satan knows Jesus' claim is to be the Son of God. If you Muslims would simply look at this, you don't even read the words you are reading that Satan knew Jesus was the Son of God. Who told Satan Jesus is the Son of God? Throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and they will lift you up in their hands, so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. Satan taunts Jesus by using the Word of God. It is roughly the same as concocting 38 misrepresentations of the Bible. Satan's tricks are not new. If you're a Christian, just pay attention to how Satan misrepresents the Word of God, how all of the claims by those who are in Islam, they cannot accurately even understand the Bible, let alone represent it correctly. Jesus answered him, it is also written, do not put the Lord your God to the test. Again, Jesus is not tempted into sin. Instead, Jesus quotes the Word of God. Maybe Jesus did not know Satan runs from the magic word Allah. If you call yourself Muslim, please tell us why Jesus did not just say Allah, 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 and make Satan run away. Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their splendor. All this I will give you, he said, if you will bow down and worship me. Lastly, Satan tries to tempt Jesus by offering worldly power. And still, Jesus does not sin. Instead, Jesus said unto him, Away from me, Satan, for it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only. If you examine the phrase, the Lord your God, the words Jesus says are recorded in Greek, but he is referring to two scriptures in Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 6:13, you shall fear only the Lord Yahweh, your God, and you shall worship him and swear by his name. Only the Lord Yahweh, your God, and you will swear by his name. Deuteronomy 10:20, you shall fear the Lord Yahweh, your God. You shall serve him and cling to him, and you shall swear by his name, Yahweh. So even here, Jesus uses God's true name, Yahweh, Jehovah, and does not say Allah, Allah, Allah to scare Satan away. So let's look again at the 3 points of the Mohammedan claim. 1. The devil attacks your God Jesus. Simply did not happen. So this claim is false. Deprived him of food and drink for 40 days. Again, false. Jesus fasted, which is a righteous act, and commanded Jesus to worship him. Again, absolutely false. Satan did not command Jesus. He tried to tempt Jesus. So as far as I can tell, this whole claim is from the beginning to an end, a fraud that is intellectually bankrupt. This should be a lesson for every Christian watching this. Never, ever trust what a Mohammedan says the Bible says. Look up every single quote. Look it up in context. Look it up in multiple translations. Study the Word of God to be a workman who needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Now look at the Mohammedan claim again. According to Muhammad's Quran, the Satan, Kanas, the one who escapeth when the name of God is mentioned. Quran 114:4 is the reference cited. Well, at first glance, that sounds pretty good. Satan runs away when the magic word Allah, Allah, Allah is used. But let's look at Surah 114:4 in context. 114:3, the Illah, or God of mankind, the God or judge of mankind, the God of mankind, the God of mankind. From the evil of the whisperer who withdraws, from the mischief of the whisperer who withdraws, from the evil of the sneaking whisperer, from the evil of the retreating whisperer, who whispers in the breasts of mankind, who whispers into the hearts of mankind, who whispereth into the hearts of mankind, who whispers evil into the hearts of and breasts of mankind. Now just hold on 1 minute. From the evil of the whisperer who withdraws. That's Surah 114:4. Not one mention of Allah, or even God, or Illah there. The problem is that Surah 114:4 and 3 and 5 do not say Satan runs from the name of Allah, or even from the word God. It just says he, Satan, withdraws. The claim is that the Quran says Satan is he who escapes when the word Allah or God is mentioned, which kind of makes this claim a fraud to begin with as well. So the first thing to realize about this Quran's reference is that it does not say what the claim says. If you call yourself Muslim, I have a sincere question for you. Do you place any value in the truth? I have showed you this claim by Islam is a lie and a fraud. Both the claim of what the Bible says and the claim what the Quran says. How much deception and lying do you people tolerate? Do you submit to an Allah of lies and fraud? Or do you wish to find al-Haq, the truth? Jesus declared, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. Hunger for the truth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, Al-Haq, the truth, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.